Greetings, family. Thank you so much for joining me today here on The New Wife. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. Today is our Tuesday 5 to 15 minute fill-ups. Please make sure if you have not that you like, share, and subscribe to this channel. I am truly enjoying this journey and it means a lot when I get a subscriber. It's just exciting. That lets me know that this is helping someone else and that's really what I'm here for, to be honest. So, today we are going to talk about what have you said yes to. Now, I know you're probably like, what do you mean? Like, you know, what have I said yes to? So, there are a lot of things we can talk on a bigger scale or a smaller scale that we may have said yes to that we didn't think through, that we are unconsciously saying yes to, not being, you know, honest with ourselves about saying yes to. So, for instance, have we said yes to a relationship maybe that we shouldn't have? Have we said yes to a job or a position maybe that we shouldn't have? Have we said yes to maybe things that people have pronounced to us or said over us or said about us that we will never, you know, be able to start our business, that we will always be in that dead-end job, that we will never reach our fullest potential? Like, what are things that we have said yes to? For instance, have we said yes to being overweight? Have we said yes to, you know, oh, I know I shouldn't eat that, but I'm gonna eat it anyway, because girl, you know, that's my favorite snack. And you know, have we said yes to that? Have we said yes and agreed to a bank maybe denying us a business loan? Have we said yes to those things? Have we just kind of went with the flow? You know what I mean? Just like, okay, well, they denied me, so that's the end of it. No. And I think sometimes, as women, we get so bogged down by things that are going on in our lives, in our home, things maybe with our children, with our husband, with our family, with our sisters, with our parents. And we just say yes to those things. We just kind of just go with them. We don't think about them. Even if somebody says, hey, I'm having a get together at my house, I wanted to know if you could cook for it. You're like, oh, okay, cool. When is it? Oh, it's tomorrow. Well, honey, did you take any consideration to my schedule, to what I may have planned, to anything that I may have going on? Or do you just expect me to say yes because I normally always say yes? So there are some times where we have to really take a step back and say, wait a minute. Am I just saying yes out of feeling bad, feeling guilty? Or am I honoring myself enough to say, you know what, unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to help you with that because that's tomorrow and I actually have a plan to spend time with my family, or to it's actually tomorrow's my self-care day. Maybe tomorrow's my rest day, you know? So I'm saying to you to do some self-evaluation to what things you have said yes to that you didn't talk to God about, that you didn't consider what you have going on. Now, I'm not saying, please don't get this confused, that I'm saying to that some of the things you may have said yes to may have added to your schedule, which is understandable. But if that's something that God is calling you to, or God has told you to do, or given you permission to do, then that's different. But what I'm challenging you to do today is to evaluate things that you have said yes to or accepted that you, one, should not have said yes to, two, should not have said accepted, or three, should not just be going along with. That's what I'm necessarily talking to you about today. That's what I'm challenging you with today. So there was a scripture that I actually read this morning this way. Jeremiah chapter 3. It says, call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. So for me, that means talk to God. Y'all know sometimes I'm saying the same things because sometimes, you know, these heads, we don't get it. So we're saying, talk to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. That right there already says we don't know it all. Hello, it doesn't matter your age, how long you've been on this earth, we don't know it all. One of the things about my papa, Lord rest his soul, he always said, There's always room to learn something. You could be 99. There's always room to learn something from someone, from an experience, from God. We will never know it all. So what I am challenging you to do today is to reassess what things you have accepted or said yes to that you shouldn't. Because honestly, there are things that you can change. Me eating, me eating chips and cookies and what's my other stuff I like? Chocolate. After a certain time, honey, I need to stop saying yes to that because I have a wedding in December. Love you, Toya, that I'm in. And I got to be, you know, I got to have this thing ready for December, walking down that aisle. You know what I'm saying? So what things have we said yes to? Have we said yes to, well, you know, my family was raised in the project, so, you know, that's just where I'm, you know, that's where I'm at and that's where I'm going to stay. Oh, I lived here all my life. Okay, that's wonderful. Is that where God is calling you to stay? So sometimes we have to just check ourselves and really see what we have said yes to unwillingly, willingly, unconsciously, and understand that we will have to show people how to respect our time, our gifts, and we also need to be conscious and aware that we are respecting their time and their gifts as well. So I hope that helped you. Again, that was Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 1. Not verse 1, y'all. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3. I encourage you to read that. So I'm going to pray. I hope this helped you, challenged you. And don't just accept what people choose to give you, honey. No. It's just like when I was younger and I would go to the store for my grandmother or go for myself or whatever. And I would come back home with no bag. My grandma would send my happy tail right on back around that corner to go get a bag because to her that was, you spent your money there. They at least owe you at minimum to give you a bag to put your stuff in. So don't just accept what people choose to give you. No, honor yourself. Honor yourself first. And if you can honor yourself first, then you'll be able to honor those around you. And not even just those around you, but people that you don't even know, the cashier, the person washing your car. Honor them. Honor yourself first. Okay? What have you said yes to that you need to say no to? Hello. So check that out. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you, we glorify you. We thank you that you have said yes to us, that you love us, that you are using us, that you appreciate us. The Lord, help us to evaluate our lives and to figure out what it is that we need to say no to, what it is that we have been accepting that we should not be accepting, the Lord. Cause us to check ourselves first, to check our households, the Lord, to understand that we should be saying yes to generational wealth, that we should be saying yes to the authority you have placed in our life, meaning you are our authority, Father. We should be saying yes to you first. Show us what we need to remove out of our lives, what we need to reevaluate, how to balance our life, dear Lord, with following you and handling our responsibilities and using these gifts and these books and these amazing things that you have locked up in us. Not, I won't say locked up, but in us that we have not released to you. So we say yes to you. We say yes to the calling you have placed in our life. We say yes to living our life to the full, which is what your word says. I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly or to the full. So that's what we choose to say yes to today. We say yes to you first. And Father, then guide us and show us what we need to say yes to next. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Love y'all. Peace. Check your yes. Everything and everybody does not deserve your yes. Hello. Love y'all. Bye.